The male hormone testosterone has various function and it acts in various phases of life, either in its basic form, that is testosterone, or after getting converted to dihydrotestosterone by the enzyme 5-alpha reductase, which is present in the cytoplasm of cell. Also, it can even get converted to another hormone, estrogen. So, its functions may be by direct action of testosterone or by dihydrotestosterone or as estrogen. So let us see which of these forms causes which functions. First of all, testosterone is produced from genital ridge from 7th week of intrauterine life, and then it is produced from testis. So remember, testosterone is not required for the development of testis since it is being produced from it. But it is required in fetal life for the differentiation of Wolfian ducts into male reproductive tract. So development of testes doesn't depend on testosterone, but the male reproductive tract, that is epididymis, vas deferens, ejaculatory duct, seminal vesicles and prostate gland. They all depend on the testosterone. Not only that, it is the development which is caused by testosterone. Also, in adult life, the tract has to be maintained also. So, if testosterone is not there, then there will be degeneration in these parts of the male reproductive tract. So, it also causes the maintenance of these parts of male reproductive tract. Then, just before birth, it is required for the descent of testes from abdomen to scrotum. So these are the functions of testosterone before birth, that is the development of male reproductive tract and for the descent of testes. Then after birth till puberty, we see that testosterone levels actually decline and it again comes into role at puberty, and then throughout adulthood it is present. So at puberty, what are its functions? Well, first and foremost is spermatogenesis. So the formation of the sperms depends on testosterone. Then growth of external genitalia and development of secondary sexual characteristics. So external genitalia, that is a penis and scrotum, depend on the presence of testosterone and development of secondary sexual characteristics. So what are these secondary sexual characteristics? Well, these include increase in protein formation and muscle development. And by virtue of increased protein formation, it also causes increase in bone matrix, causing thickening of bone along with deposition of calcium salts. Then it is responsible for male pattern distribution of hair, that is hair over pubis, which extends up to umbilicus, and then appearance of beard over face, appearance of hair over chest, and male pattern baldness. Then it causes thickening of skin and increase in secretion from sebaceous glands, which is responsible for appearance of acne at puberty. Plus there are many other changes which occur, like the changes in voice which occurs, and that is due to the hypertrophy of the laryngeal mucosa, enlargement of larynx, and vocal cords also increase in length and thickness. So all this leads to deepening of voice. Then changes in torso, the male body contour which develops. Changes in pelvis, so it causes narrow pelvic outlet, which is in contrast to that of females who have broad pelvis. Then it causes a strengthening of the pelvis for weight bearing. Plus there are also changes in mental attitude. So it is responsible for aggressive behavior of males and increase in sex drive. Now, among all the functions which we have just seen, which are the functions caused by testosterone, which are by dihydrotestosterone, and which by estrogen? So let us try to categorize them. See, testosterone is responsible for development of internal genitalia during fetal life. That is the male reproductive tract which we were talking about. And also for their maintenance throughout adult life. Then, in adults, it is also directly responsible for spermatogenesis and male libido. Plus, for secondary sexual characteristic, it is responsible for protein anabolic effect. Now, dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone, we said that it is formed in the cytoplasm where 5-alpha reductase enzyme acts on testosterone and causes the formation of dihydrotestosterone. So this is responsible for development and enlargement of external genitals, that is penis and scrotum, and also for the development of prostate gland. Now, you might be aware that there is something known as benign prostatic hyperplasia, and in this condition, if we give a drug, a finasteride, which is a 5-alpha reductase blocker, so it blocks the enzyme 5-alpha reductase, so what will happen? Dihydrotestosterone will not be able to form from testosterone. So obviously, it will not be able to act on prostate gland. So that is the reason that finasteride, which is a 5-alpha reductase blocker, works in benign prostatic hyperplasia. Fine. So DHT is responsible for development and enlargement of external genitals. Then this enzyme 5-alpha reductase is also present in cells of skin and scalp. So you can guess, I think here, that if it is present on a scalp, then male pattern baldness will be due to what? It will be due to dihydrotestosterone. Then growth of facial hair, development of acne and hairline recession, all are due to DHT because this enzyme is present in skin and scalp. By the way, you should remember one thing, that the formation of DHT is a way of amplifying the action of testosterone on the target tissues. Because what happens that this DHT and testosterone combine with the same receptor. But the combination of DHT with that receptor is more stable than that of the testosterone receptor complex, and that is why it is able to act better. So this is a way of amplifying the action of testosterone in the tissues. Now you just remember this, because in the end we are going to solve one question and it is very interesting to know this concept. Now finally, testosterone, as I said earlier, can also act after getting converted to the hormone estrogen. So estrogen is very important for spermatogenesis. So it plays a role in spermatogenesis. In epididymis, actually, it is present, and it is responsible for fluid resorption from there. So estrogen is important for spermatogenesis. And estrogen is also responsible for attraction of males to opposite sex. So it acts on brain cells and is responsible for heterosexuality. And finally, estrogen is also responsible for closure of the epiphysis. So testosterone is converted into estrogen in bone also. So testosterone is directly causing the bone growth, but the closure of epiphysis occurs when testosterone gets converted to estrogen. By the way, it's the enzyme aromatase which acts on testosterone and converts testosterone to estrogen. Okay, so these were the functions of testosterone, which acts as directly as testosterone, dihydrotestosterone or estrogen. But before closing, as I mentioned earlier, let's try to answer one question. What will be the problem in a child with congenital deficiency of 5-alpha reductase? So here are some four options given. Whether the problem will be in spermatogenesis, whether the problem will be in Wolfian duct formation, that is the formation of the male reproductive tract, will it cause Wolfian duct regression as the option says, or it will cause male pseudohermaphroditism, or it will cause short stature. Well, the answer here is C, male pseudohermaphroditism. Very interesting it is. First of all, what is pseudohermaphroditism? Well, it means that internal genitals are normal, like that of male, but external genitals are looking like that of female. Now, we have said that testosterone directly is responsible for formation of internal genitals, while for the development and enlargement of external genitals, dihydrotestosterone is needed. And this is formed when 5-alpha reductase enzyme acts on testosterone, isn't it? So, in this case, internal genitals will be that of male, while external genitals will look like that of a female. So that is why in this case, the person is suffering from male pseudohermaphroditism. So what happens that such a male is actually raised as a female, but at puberty, some growth of genital occurs because at puberty there is high concentration of testosterone. And even though the amplifying effect of dihydrotestosterone is not there, but yet testosterone, by virtue of increased concentration, starts having some effect on the external genitals, right? And this causes the development of the genitals, and the body contour also changes, and the libido develops. So these children are raised as females but later on convert to males. Fine. So that's the answer to this question. But quickly, you might have understood that why the other things will not occur. Well, first option, spermatogenesis. We said testosterone is directly responsible for spermatogenesis. Then Wolfian duct regression will not occur because it is the testosterone in its form only that causes the development of male internal genitals. And short stature again will not be there because the protein anabolic effect, which causes increase in growth, is again directly by the hormone testosterone. So that's all for the functions of testosterone. If you like the video, do press the like button and do share the video with others. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel Physiology Open. Thank you.